return to the Intelligent Agenda.
Okay, we're back on the Intelligent Agenda with me, Mike Riley. Let's bring out our next guest. Brandon, can you hang out for a while?
You got it, man.
All right, scooch on over the couch there. All right, next up, he's an actor as well, but has gotten into politics by running for governor of our state. You may have seen the TV commercials for John Hunter where he accuses Michael Graves of all kinds of nasty things. Well, here he is, John Hunter.
Wow, thank you. I mean, that's really wonderful.
Wow, you look great, John.
Thank you, thanks.
How's the campaign going?
Mike, it's just fantastic. We're making a difference by giving the networks millions of dollars to run campaign ads. It's democracy at a grassroots level. Fundraising has gone really well. I haven't sold myself out at all. I've learned a lot being an actor, you know, on the set during years of bit parts. I want to bring the reality of TV dramas from the lots of Vinewood to our state.
Wow, look at that. The phones are exploding. Line three, Sarah.
Hi, Mike. I'm a huge fan and a committed swinger. Maybe you'd like to come to one of our parties. Hi, Brandon. I love that art house film you made when you painted a picture with your junk. John, I'm a concerned parrot. How are you going to help me make the world safer for my kids?
Well, Sarah, if you vote for me, things will change.
That's a relief.
There's a lot that I'm doing to help parents. I mean, now you take the internet. What happens when kids can post on the internet on their own pages?
Oh, like myroomonline.net.
Yeah. I don't understand it. I come from a different generation, when it was okay to carpet bomb first and ask questions later. But people have to understand that the internet is a series of cubes, and strange men want to put their privates in the other side of that tube and right into your child's bedroom. As a conservative liberal, I feel it's my duty to try it. Buy a financial stake in it, and then regulate it. It's a win-win. And the best bit is, we can all feel guilty together.
Wow, let's go back to the phones then. Steve, you're on Intelligent Agenda.
Hi, Mr. Hunter. I really enjoy your campaign commercials. It's the best part of election season. The 18 months of attack ads where you have no clue what's going on, and you learn to hate everyone.
Oh, thank you. Thank you very much.
I was hoping you could do something about these air shows. Why do planes have to fly so close together over a crowd of people? Oh boy, there's a jet farting smoke. Big deal! It's polluting the atmosphere. People are actually shocked when these planes crash. Jeez, you can do a lot too with your wind in it. Air shows suck ass.
Now, safety is one of the main parts of my campaign. We've had enough of these dividers. We want the whole enchilada to come together as a nation because we all like Mexican food. Now let's stop big government running things for the little guy. I want to make sure everyone has access to opportunities they
can afford. Hey, Nico, it's Michelle.
It's the American way.
We met with Mallory, Roman's girlfriend.
I remember. What's up, Michelle?
I don't normally do this, but I thought you'd probably be pretty lonely having just moved to Liberty City and all.
You do not normally do what?
You're not making this easy for me, are you? I'm asking you out on a date.
I am sorry. I am still not used to how things work here in America. A date would be good. I am getting sick of hanging out with Roman all the time. How about I pick you up from your apartment?
That sounds good. See you soon.
And buy uniforms, balls, and then the books, if we can afford them. I learned a lot playing a part of American culture, TV, movie, and
maybe what we need is a good old-fashioned peasant.
Exactly. Freedom within reasons. Responsible government taking away choices people don't need. Right now, what we have is a war on science. The FDA is denying access to a new drug that causes superfertility. Can you imagine the
What does he want?
Oh, I can't think what he can possibly want. Or why he's being pissed off. Can you? Come on, guys. Let's be reasonable.
Companies so they can turn a profit. it's important that our children see us taking xenophobia seriously. Otherwise, what are they going to learn from?
Speaking of kids, we should take a quick break and get our next guest out here. Get this. He's 11. He's a super genius. Back after this.
Virtually. products are sold.
WKTT 1066. Because the family is under attack and it's time to fight back.
Celebrities are what matters in America. And we watch their every move.
And Jeffron James, and I have been out.
Fuck!
Jail made me grow up fast, man.
Guess what, gangster? You're getting jacked.
You got me.
You never have to worry about your children being exposed to profanity, nudity, bestiality, polygamy, drug or alcohol use, mooning, heavy petting, teabagging, attractive... homosexuality or science. The Vindication Angel Curse Buster BC. It's time to start editing reality.
Here we go.
These girls coming again.
Whoa!
Stay, baby. Whoa! You're turning into crap, baby!
merchandise, you...
Oh, yeah, and banging hookers.
Also in patriotism news, brought to you by the hit TV show 72, counterterrorism officials are setting up a new task force to deal with the rising Eastern European crime wave in Liberty City.
In other terror news, a scare in Midtown as a warning horn sent tourists running in panic as a green smoke was emitted. Officials indicated the horn is a new deodorant only meant to terrorize the ladies.
I'd like to spray some in your face.
I wish you would. The body of ship captain Zorba Philippidis was found floating in the Humboldt yesterday. An autopsy has revealed dangerous amounts of alcohol in his system.
At first, I thought it was a whale. Like that one that got beached on Happiness Island last summer. I brought my kids over to take a look. Then I saw it was a body. God, I'm so stupid. I can't believe they let me breathe.
Captain Philippidis was... vessel that recently docked at East Hook Bay. The rest of the crew are currently unaccounted for. Authorities are making inquiries. More people fall unconscious to Weasel News than any other news source.
This is Weasel News.
No, it's nice to be on the bright side of a fusion reaction. This is Fusion FM.
Steve, you're on Intelligent Agenda.
Hi, Mr. Hunter. I really enjoy your campaign commercials. It's the best part of election season. The 18 months of attack ads where you have no clue what's going on, and you learn to hate everyone.
Well, thank you. Thank you very much.
I was hoping you could do something about these air shows. Why do planes have to fly so close together over a crowd of people? Oh, boy. There's a jet farting smoke. Big deal. It's polluting the atmosphere. People are actually shocked when these planes crash. Gee, you're doing Mach 2 with your wings an inch apart.
Now, safety is one of the main parts of my campaign. We've had enough of these dividers. We want the whole enchilada to come together as a nation because we all like Mexican food. Now, let's stop being government running things for the little guy. I want to make sure everyone has access to opportunities they can afford. It's the American way. It's all in my best-selling campaign book.
Next, caller, you're on with John Hunter.
And Brandon Roberts.
Oh, yeah, of course, Brandon Roberts. Hello, Jay.
Yeah, Mr. Hunter, I have a question. What happens when dogs and cats can drive?
Now, that's one of the things we need to focus on in this country. Education. And if I'm elected governor, at least one state will have its priorities straight. Unfortunately, our schools focus on academics. Our schools in the South focus on nothing but football and procreating. We need to change the budgets to break the teachers' unions and buy uniforms, balls, and then the books if we can afford them. I learned a lot playing the part of a maverick coach in a